What's up, everybody, and welcome back to Around the Table Sports. So one thing I've been super excited to do is really do a film breakdown of a few plays from the national championship to just kind of give an example as to how elite Steve Sarkisian was in this game. It really was incredible to watch him call this game, so I really can't wait to get into this. But before we do, y'all, as always, if you're here, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. We're on our push to 1,000. We just passed 800 subscribers, and I'd love to have y'all along for the journey. For those of you that have subscribed, thank you so much for the support. It really does mean a ton. If you're here, go ahead and like the video and comment down below to let me know what you think of Sark's play calling in this game, because I think it really was masterful. But with all that being said, let's hop straight into it. So this first play, there's really not a whole lot fancy going on here, but I think it's a good play to start with because it really breaks down who Steve Sarkisian is as a play caller. So right here, this formation is something we've seen a ton from Alabama, having all their weapons on the outside and sending somebody in motion. Look, Steve Sarkisian loves pre-snap motion, more so than most offensive coordinators in the nation. So let's pause this at the top of the formation and really check this out. So we have John Metchie at the bottom, Najee in the backfield, Devonta Smith is the first wide receiver lined up on the left, followed by Jaylen Waddle and Slade Bolden. Now, Najee's the motion man, so he's just there giving eye candy. What we really need to pay attention to is where I have circled in that yellow X. The reason that's so important is Mechie's running almost the exact same route as Jaylen Waddle, just a little bit deeper, whereas Waddle's is a little bit more shallow. The reason for this is it's almost a designed rub route right there. Mechie's helping Waddle clear space by running almost into the defender following Waddle. In this case, it worked out perfectly for Mack, because all he had to do was a little pop pass forward to Jaylen Waddle to allow Waddle to continue running in stride. This is a super simple formation, but it kind of shows who Sark is. He's going to kill you with pre-snap motion, and he's going to make you pay for it by being undisciplined in some of your coverages. He's got a lot of tricks up his sleeves, and I just think this play really does a good job showing it. I also think that they saw something on this play that they really liked, because this was not even close to the first time they used similar pre-snap motion. And even though Sark does it a lot, I think that they saw that the people following whoever was on the motion man was getting there really late. I mean, it didn't matter who it was, whether it was Browning or Sean Wade, it didn't matter. They just weren't able to compete with the speed of whoever was running as the motion man for Alabama. All right, this play's kind of similar to the last one in the sense that it's not super complex. They're just giving you some eye candy. So they move the tight end, and now they have Najee right next to Mack. But watch the route combination on this play. Even though it wasn't a touchdown, this right here was a beautifully designed route combination. Forrestall almost does, once again, another little rub route running into the defender who's covering Devonta Smith. In this case, it's Sean Wade. Now, once again, Mack overthrows the ball, but you can see that 9 times out of 10, this is going to be a touchdown with the connection these two have, and it's because of the play that Sark has dialed up. And I didn't highlight it in that still, but watch the route that Mechie's running. It's just another route that's clearing space, getting the defense flowing to the inside to clear open that outside throw to Devonta Smith. Really nice stuff right here. So this next play is super interesting because once it worked, it was pretty much well the end of the game. Alabama was scoring way too easy, and this play right here was just easy mode. Sark schemed this masterfully, and Bama ran multiple variations of this exact same play, both for touchdowns and massive gains throughout the rest of this game. So let's break it down. All right, so I want to take a look at three players individually because they kind of allow for Devonta Smith to get this open. So first off, Miller Forrestall has just completed his motion to the left side of the offense's formation. Jalel Billingsley is just to the tackle's left side with Devonta Smith shading off of his hip, Najee Harris in the backfield, and John Metchie at the top of the formation. So the three players are Jalel Billingsley, because he clears through the middle of the defense, grabbing all the attention and making the defense flow left. They flow left even more when they see Devonta Smith begin his motion after the snap into the backfield to the defense's left. This is further compounded when you have Miller Forrestall clearing to the middle portion of the defense, and Najee also following Miller Forrestall in that middle. This is why when Devonta Smith breaks back to the defense's right side, there's nobody there, because the entire flow of this play had the defense going to their left, and Devonta Smith broke it off. This completely took advantage of the aggressive nature of Ohio State's defense, and Bama continuously used plays modeled just like this to make Ohio State pay and pay bad. And remember when I said they did this often? Right here, again, something super simple. have Devonta Smith go in motion, and then partway through that motion, have him double back the original way he came because the defender just cannot keep up. This time, Banks got trapped bad. Now, Sark started doing this because Ohio State, at first, was playing not to let anything get behind them, so they were letting the offense take whatever they wanted in front of them. So Sark said, fine, we're going to let you have that, but we're going to make you pay, and we're going to make you adjust because you're just not going to be able to keep up. So this next play is easily my favorite play of the game, and it's not new to this one. This is something that Alabama has run before, but Mack does a phenomenal job of selling this every single time. Smitty engages Wade on the top of the line, selling the screen, which Bama runs a healthy amount of. After that, Smitty flies off the block, and Mack gives a killer head and pump fake to John Metchie at the bottom of the route. All right, let's check this out because this was super nice, and it's not that complex. So we have Devonta Smith engaging Sean Wade on the block, like I said, but then he's going to disengage and go for the route. Now, John Metchie, while he's engaging, is going to almost bubble out. This is all well and good, but if Mac Jones doesn't sell this pump fake to John Metchie, the defense might be able to sniff it out. Now, it really helps that when the defense sees Devonta Smith engage Sean Wade on this block, they're all thinking bubble. That's only furthered when they actually see the bubble occur, and then Mac gives that killer head fake. All of this allows for Devonta Smith to just spring completely clean on the back end of this fake. This is an absolutely masterfully schemed play. Texas fans, this is why I said you should be so excited about Sark coming, because I think he's going to bring creative stuff like this with him. I know he is. And look, as beautiful as this is for me to watch, you don't think that some of the top receivers, top running backs, top quarterbacks in the nation aren't looking at a play like this and are just as wowed by this as I am because of how easy he's able to scheme this stuff? No, they're absolutely paying attention. And look, this play right here, I'm not even going to draw anything because I've said it twice in this video alone, and Sark is just making it that easy. Once again, we send Devonta Smith in motion, and as he clears through the middle, he starts doubling back the original way he came. This time, however, there's another wrinkle in that double back, because as he starts to double back to the left where he originally came from, he stops and then shoots back right the way his original motion was going. Once again, Banks can't keep up with this. This same thing Sark kept doing all game was the beginning of the end for Ohio State because they just couldn't have an answer for this pre-snap motion that Sark was running. All right, let's take a look at one more play before I hop on out of here. So this one right here is last but certainly not least. We have Najee Harris coming in motion from the right side to the left side of the formation with an empty backfield. Xavier Williams is lined up to the bottom of the formation with Slade Bolden and John Metchie towards the inside. So instantly, Xavier Williams is running straight downfield. Slade Bolden is going to kind of do a fake bubble screen. He's going to go for it a little bit and then come back to Mac Jones. Now, John Metchie really sells this. He puts up his hands as if he's about to engage in the block. And then as soon as he sees the defender realize what's about to happen, he puts down his hands and rockets downfield into the opening at the back end because all the defense thought the screen was coming. He sells this with the simple fact that he puts up his hands, showing that he's going to block. As soon as they are faked out, it's all downhill from there, and another masterclass from execution from Mac Jones, Slade Bolden, Xavier Williams, and John Metchie, but also from Steve Sarkisian. Y'all, Sark called a masterful game in this. So it was super exciting for me to go back and watch because I thought that it was one of the best games he's ever called. That's about it from me. Y'all comment down below letting me know what you thought. Drop a like on the video and subscribe to the channel. That's it. See ya.